Oh no, I see. I just need to get you on the stream somehow now. Let me see if I can do this. Hold on a second.
That's very weird.
That is very weird. Hold on a sec. Let me see if I can add something here.
I'm gonna have to mute you on the stream.
I'm saying for sure. Sorry, dude.
Oh, you can't do it, Rod. You've got to do it like that, Rod. Boy, wiki. I bought this.
Oh, there we go. There we go. Window capture. Here we go. Let me see if I can get this. Restream chat. Oh, I think I've got you. Hold on a sec. Oh, there we go. I've got you on the screen. But I don't want to cover up your character's face. Did you see? You see what I've got going on, right?
Dude, there we go. Yeah. Look. Now I can do this.
Oh, that looks actually pretty cool, actually. I'll make that a little bit bigger.
There we go. I'm now bringing... There you go, look.
Yeah, that's awesome. It's a shame you don't have your own mask in the game.
Not yet.
I was gonna try and ask you some stuff about that, but I'm sure there's a lot that you can't say.
You go ahead and ask, because I got nothing to say.
Oh, damn it then. Well, that's kind of disappointing.
And that's not because I'm on an NDA. It's because there is nothing to say.
Oh, really? Oh, damn it. Well, that's a little annoying. But maybe in the future, right?
The whole Locke Payday Twitter feed thing is... was generated initially by Kraken Gaming.
Yeah.
And my mate over there, they started this idea of the hashtag, the lock for sure.
Yeah.
With the idea that that's something that the community can use to let Starbreeze and Overkill know if they'd like more of Locke in any capacity, either as a playable character or as a contractor or whatever. So
yeah,
they're gonna pop up on the screen any second now.
you can be famous.
My daughter, there you go, look.
It's so weird how there's a delay, right?
So anyway, so whether the lines for Heat Street were as a result of that pressure or not, I have no evidence, but and you know, we got Payday 3 coming along soon, so
right.
Get the fuck up.
Who knows?
Yeah, I mean, because we were trying to connect before that, and I assume that that's what you were working on, right? The Heat Street stuff.
Yes, it was. I think maybe the day after we agreed to connect, I got the email. And of course, then everything had to stop, didn't it? But I couldn't say why.
No, of course not. No, and I totally understand. I was like, oh, he just went quiet all of a sudden.
Yeah. Oh, God. Oh.
Yeah, no, it's like, did I offend him? No, I'm just kidding.
So I spent a little bit of time swearing in my very bad South African accent.
I don't think it's bad. I thought, because obviously you're English, right?
Correct.
So whereabouts are you from?
Yeah, see, all these accents that I do come largely from the fact that I never lived in one place for very long.
Oh, okay.
So I spent a few years on the South Coast. I spent a few years in Scotland. I spent a few years in East Anglia. I spent a few years in Kent. I spent a few years in the northwest of England.
Yeah.
Up lad, you know. Then I moved to Holland, where we kind of speak a little bit like that. And then you meet a few South Africans, and it's not very far from Dutch to a really gruff South African.
Almost Scottish a little bit.
Then
up
in the back of your throat, and you get much closer to Locke.
Yeah.
You know, I'll say, you see my mouth, I'm like, you know, you...
You have to do the phase, right?
Somewhere, you know, there might be young people listening or something.
That's so cool.
So absolutely. Locke has been brilliantly cool for me.
Is it a lot of work or?
The two heists, Birth of Sky and Beneath the Mountain, were probably 3 or 4 days' work.
Damn, really, that much?
Well, because you can't record continuously, especially when it's not in your natural voice.
Right.
So you work at it, you chip away at it, and then of course you send something over and they don't like it and they send it back and say, you know, you're rubbish, do it again.
In those words.
Completely. That's
it. Yeah.
message which says, that's rubbish, do it again. broadly, the conversation I had initially was I sent over a little bit and they came back and they gave some feedback. Then I sent some more stuff over and the comment then was they thought that I had found my inner lock.
Interesting.
And then off you go. 2 days later, you know, you've churned out all this stuff. The editing, you don't have to edit everything to broadcast quality most of the time, but you do have, you know, you make mistakes, you know, and you have to say lines again, and you cut all that out. So that actually takes more time than recording itself. Roughly 2 to 1. So an hour of voice will take about 2 hours to edit down. Or an hour and a half if it's, you know, if you're good.
Do you edit it yourself? Like, do you like master it and then send it over, or no?
No.
Just like raw file.
That's the funniest thing I've heard in months.
I give you too much credit for that one.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah. So they get, if I were to speak to you, I'd say, Rod, you're okay, boys, we're going to go and we're going to beat up on some murkies or something like that. Everything else, the crackle, the post, the music, everything, it's nothing to do.
Oh, okay. You're just raw files. How many lines do you have to... Oh, can you hear me that way?
Yeah, because that was...
Oh, that was the stream?
That was for the stream.
Oh, okay.
Still got, you know, look like a numpty.
Numpty. How many lines do you have to record? Because I've looked at voice packs that are in the game, and there's like 700 lines, but how many have you got, do you know?
No
idea, right? It's just
I record those two heists. I mean, it's 2.5 years ago.
Yeah, it's a while.
It was around Christmas of 2015.
Yeah.
Just around maybe November of 2015 that I recorded them. And of course, it all went silent after that. There was nothing.
Yeah, true.
And, you know, as a voice actor, my job is to hunt new work.
Right.
So I forgot all about it and you move on. That whole charity stream thing happened and Locke has taken on a little life of his own since then.
That's awesome. How did you first get in touch with it?
Sorry, say again?
How did you first get in with Overkill and start the process?
Well, there are lots of... The internet has changed the world massively.
Yeah, for sure.
We wouldn't be doing this without the internet.
No.
And Payday wouldn't exist without the internet. The whole streaming community wouldn't exist. And with acting's largely the same. A great deal of work is you find on various casting portals on the internet, and you know they posted the need for a voice in a South African accent. So I thought, oh, I'll do that. Oh, I've got I can do anything, me. So I did it, and they picked me.
That's so cool.
The rest is history, really.
And hopefully the future too, right?
Well, you know, from a mercenary point of view, which of course Locke is, they hire me, they have to pay me some money. So that's, of course.
But this is your full-time gig now, right?
Everybody's listening.
Yeah. Anyone influential, yeah.
This is my full-time occupation. This is what I do for a living.
How cool is that to do for a living, though?
Someone on the Twitter feed, one of Locke's followers, asked me, he said, innocently, was I having a good day?
Yeah.
Just a little throwaway comment, and I said, "Are you kidding? I get up in the morning, I go into my in here. This is my we're sat in my control room.
Okay,
behind me.
Yeah,
and over here, behind the flag.
Oh, I like the flag.
Well, that's the door to my booth in there.
Oh, very professional.
This microphone here is normally in there.
Okay."
Because I thought we'd be using it, but so I come in here and I look and see what's available to have a go at, and I go into the booth and I wave my arms around and I swear and I smile and I giggle and I create new characters every day, dozens of times a day for auditions, and and I have great fun. And really, am I having a good day?
I know, kid? Right?
So, yes, of course, I feel completely lucky to be able to do what I do.
That's amazing. Because were you in sales before or something? I saw something like you were in sales for like 20 years or something.
Almost 30 years, yeah.
Damn.
Don't tell anybody this, but I worked for a bank for a decade.
Really? Don't tell the 500 people watching,
don't,
right?
Don't tell the people that are watching.
No. Nah. Okay, between me and you.
Yeah, yeah. Just keep it. I'll tell you. Okay, so here's a good story that people will maybe like to hear. But one of the, you know, often people say, "How did you get started?"
Yeah.
Back in the mists of time, I was a stage actor.
Yeah.
Which, of course, didn't pay the bills, so I had to give it up and go and work for a bank. But my wife had never seen me act because I met her after I'd finished with that.
Mm-hmm.
So for a Christmas present, she bought me a one-day introduction to voice acting in London when we were living near Oxford.
Okay.
So I got on a train and went up to to London from Oxford and met this this guy there and had the one-day introduction, and it was great fun. And I turned up again for a few more of their workshops, and then sort of 3 years later, the credit crunch and all the, you know, banks don't need anybody anymore and nobody loves banks and we'd really like some people to put their hand up and volunteer to, you know, to go away. So
right.
Eventually I said, yeah, I'll do that. And we moved to the States, and I thought, well, okay, I've got to, because my wife's American.
Yeah.
So I had to think about what I was going to do. And I thought, oh, I did that voice acting thing. I'll have a go at that.
Wow.
I went back up to London for a day to record my first demo reels, and I asked the producer, will anyone ever hire me? Really? You know, am I wasting my time?
Yeah.
And he said, I don't see why not. So I arrived in the States, and I met some people here, and I was invited to go to an agent workshop about a week after I'd arrived.
Mm.
And I approached the agent afterwards and I said, so what do I do next? And he said, well, I guess I put you on my books.
I guess.
So having picked myself up from, get the fuck up, someone said to me, because I'd fallen on the floor at that point. And so within a week, I had my first agent, and it was just surreal.
Wow.
And in fact, the reason I was late joining was he phoned me, that agent phoned me, an audition that I'd done earlier today.
Yeah.
I don't know if I can mention, well, I suppose I can mention the company, but for Samsung.
Yeah, you sent that, yeah.
I had recorded the wrong bit,
mm-hmm.
But they really liked my voice. So he was desperate to get me to do a second audition because they were asking for more.
Yeah.
So around 6:10, that was when I got that phone call. So I then got to go back in the booth, record, edit.
Oh, wow.
So I've done that. And so now I can join you. But now I'm like this for a Samsung gig, which would be...
That's really cool.
Through an agent. Agents play proper money.
Do they really? Especially someone big like Samsung.
This online shit.
Yeah, right, seriously. Would that be like... Is that like a national campaign? You're allowed to see what it's for, yeah. Or do you know? You don't know.
No idea.
Yeah.
It's like video games. A lot of video games, you'll be cast. You'll know what you're reading, but you won't know for what game it is. So I didn't know when I ordered the lines for Locke that it was for Payday. I had no idea. I didn't know.
Had you heard of Payday before or no? No.
No. And it was very obvious when I went on that first stream with Crark and Graham, and all these people were like your stream thing where people are putting comments up.
Yeah.
Giggling about how clearly I knew nothing. Which was completely true.
You
I knew nothing.
Are bloody professionals.
You know, I've learned a fair amount since.
I'm sure.
The Twitter thing with Locke Payday, I go on there most days for 10 or 15 minutes.
Yeah.
Code and sharing my little thoughts of the day.
I've got to say, your Twitter feed is one of the best ones that I follow for sure.
Oh, for sure.
For sure, yeah. I'm actually, because I've got it on screen, so I've got it on screen for everyone to, so they can follow you on there, because I know you're really active on there. It's really cool.
Yeah, this is, like I said, this is my full-time occupation, but that doesn't mean that I'm stood in front of a microphone 24. Right. And I think that one of the things about Locke is voice acting is very, it's not lonely because you've got hundreds of people
in your head
up here, you know, yeah. around.
Yeah.
It is largely solitary.
Yeah.
I'm work. It's me. It's just me and the computer and the microphone. So the Twitter followers and, you know, Locke's fans, if you like, it gives me a release from that. It allows me to talk with, I was about to say human beings, but I'm not sure that's going too far. But,
you know,
it's
been
fun.
Yeah.
It gives me a bit of interaction, which I enjoy.
Yeah, that's so cool.
Well, one of the other things I did was having got sort of 2.5 years, 3 years into a full-time career with voice acting, was I started wanting to give back, and I now run some introduction to voice acting courses locally.
Oh, wow.
And one of Locke's followers said, oh, I wish I could do something like that.
Uh-huh.
On the you know, I do most of my things on private messaging when I'm talking to individuals.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of that stuff you don't want out in the...
No, of course.
And the codes, I'll come back to the codes, but it turned out he lives less than 2 hours away from where my workshop was going to be. And so he paid his money down and came to my...
No.
Which was completely cool for me.
That's amazing.
Cool for him as well, but it was completely cool for me.
Yeah, it's like, was he your first person in?
He was the first person to arrive, yes, yeah. And the last person to leave.
Hey, oh, yeah, mate.
And he posted a picture.
That's so cool.
He put a picture up on Twitter of it, of us together, you know, arm in arm, as it were.
Wow. And you're in South Carolina?
Yeah. I took some of these masks with me, and I signed them.
That's amazing.
Yeah, I'm in South Carolina, yes.
Yeah, have you always lived in South Carolina?
No.
Oh.
No, I've lived in, I was counting it up. I've lived in, if you count England, Scotland and Wales as different countries.
Yeah.
I've lived in 6 different countries now.
You got to list them for us.
Well, England.
Yeah. Scotland, also, yeah.
Belgium.
Ooh.
The Netherlands.
Yeah.
And the USA.
In the US. And just in the US, South Carolina.
Yeah, we moved here 3 years ago.
Yeah.
Or quite 3 years ago. Oddly, at the time, it was summertime, so there were 4 of us, and it was cheaper to book the 4 of us on the Queen Mary from Southampton to New York than it was to fly 4 of us to South Carolina.
No.
So we took a week's cruise on the Queen Mary 2 from Southampton to New York, 2 days, 2 nights in New York, 3 days, and then down to South Carolina for the same price. Once we added the hotel and the
New
York and the trip from New York down, for the same price as it would have cost for 4 flights.
How was the cruise? I've heard that cruise exists, and I always thought about taking it back home one time. But
yeah, it's you know, if you're a very active person,
get the fuck up.
The days can get a bit long.
Yeah, I can imagine.
You know, one of the things about cruising is all these things to look at, but when you're out in the middle of the Atlantic, there really isn't very much to look at.
Not particularly, oh, no.
Look, it's the sea.
Oh, more water.
Oh, more sea.
Oh, a bird. Yeah.
And then someone will go, oh, look, there's a dolphin, and everybody will run to one side of the ship, heel over.
Yeah.
Gone, and nobody will have seen it. So
that's awesome.
No, it was fine. No, it was fun. It was good. It was a nice and relaxing. I've got to say, it was very relaxing.
Yeah, I can imagine.
So,
that's great.
So, yes, you're obviously not hailing from these parts either.
No, I am not. No, I've been over here about 10 years or so now, but I'm originally from Nottingham. That's pretty much all the places I lived in England. I lived in North London for about a year and a half before I moved to America. But originally from the Midlands.
It was a stopover while you were waiting for your ticket.
Yeah, it was a stopover at Heathrow, and that was about it, yeah. But yeah, I've been over here for a while now. My wife's from New York, and I'm pretty settled here now too, so I love it.
She's a New Yorker.
She's in New York, she's from Long Island, so she's got a little bit of a crazy accent too.
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure. For sure.
For sure.
Always comes back. Yeah.
So let me one thing, because I don't know if you know, but I spoke with the voice actor for Sydney Georgia. I don't know if you've met any of those guys.
No.
No, you never met him or anything.
I've twitted, if that's the phrase.
Oh, twitted. That's got to be the name for it.
And I have actually, hang on just a second. This one is signed by Eric and Georgia.
Oh, that's really cool.
Well, this sits on my wall over here.
That's awesome. Did you ever make it to one of the Payday cons or anything?
Not yet.
Not yet. Oh, so do you know if there's going to be one this year? No idea.
No. I'm you know, voice actors, by and large, are the mushrooms of the world.
Right. The mushrooms?
Yeah. Have you not heard that one?
No.
Kept in the dark and fed on shit.
I like it. So you just feel, oh, okay, that's interesting. So you're not really privy to any kind of info or anything.
No, I had a question from someone who I can't tell you the name of, or I'd have to fucking kill you. they asked me where I lived.
Yeah.
As this was someone needing to know for a reason, and I don't know what,
like,
that reason.
Like address or city? Like, what did they need?
They just asked where I lived.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
So I said South Carolina.
Right.
It's no great secret.
No, it's not. No, I found it on the internet by searching your name.
Well, thank you. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, and as a small businessman, as an entrepreneur, if you like, you
right.
can't.
Right. No, yeah. I mean, yeah, you dig enough, you can find pretty much anything about anybody.
Yeah, there's one guy, he said he would come on the stream this evening, and he's desperate to find out exactly how old I am.
I see it on Twitter pretty much every day, people are guessing your age, and you kind of just play around with it. And then you revealed that your daughter was 20 or something, so everyone's like, okay, so if she's 20, then you did this.
You should
and
then... see on the private messaging some of the
God.
Logical arguments that have been put together for why... And it's great fun, and I apologize now for being secretive about it, but you know, it's you're giving me the opportunity to have fun, so
right now it's a game.
We'd have stopped by now, but the fact that you care is just wonderful.
Well, we could ask the chat now and they can put some numbers out there. The desperate
yeah,
guy
there
is
that desperate guy
is it
me.
Sunny yeah, yeah it's Sunny, right? Yeah. One of the first questions that came up in the chat when you came on was, ask him how old he is.
Well, my normal thing is, so how old do you think I look?
Right. That's always a good question. Then people are all over the map, right?
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. In fact, my first job out of college was as a teacher. So at the time I was in my early 20s.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the kids said, how old are you? And I said, how old do you think I am? And we were around the class and people had anything from 20 to 50.
Right.
I'm thinking, the people saying that I was 50 when I was in my, you know, I'm not
early
sure
20s.
How, you know.
Yeah, it's not a good day, that one.
If people said I was 20, I would be quite happy.
Right, of course, yeah. People are saying, let me see what we've got. You can probably see it. 47,
oh,
58,
age.
53, no. 56.
Yeah. Oh, yes, okay, yeah. Lots of people saying lots of different things.
48. Someone said 12.
That would be my mental age. Yeah,
okay,
would...
good. Yeah, you're about where I am with that then. Yeah.
And the other thing as a voice actor is they tend to classify roles as either young adult, middle-aged, or senior.
Right, yeah.
And I've recorded for all of those.
Oh, interesting. I guess you can put on an old voice, right, if you really had to.
Yeah, I have a sort of like an Ian McKellen sort of old, you know. You shall not pass.
That's awesome.
That sort of thing.
Yeah.
And in fact, I don't think it's live, but it might be. There's a prologue I recorded for a Steam video game called Heroes and Kings.
Okay.
And I've never seen the video. I've never seen the final result. But that was what, like a sort of a magician going, we're in the time of such and such.
Oh,
know?
Very cool.
That was one of those. And I haven't had confirmation yet, but I'm at least shortlisted for another job like that, which would be...
Oh, that's cool. Are you in any other video games, or was this your only one?
I've lost count.
Oh, you're in that many?
I'm in quite a few, but a lot of it is... a lot of the work I get is prologues.
Okay.
You know, or little cutscenes, you know, where they want a bit of a story told.
Okay.
So I think I sent you a link to... I didn't know whether you'd be able to show these things, but there's a bit like Payday, where it's an online global Steam kind of thing called Endless Space.
Okay.
So it's a space universe game.
Yeah.
And I recorded about a year ago the prologue. There are five factions who are fighting for control of the universe.
Yeah.
One of the factions is called the Cravers.
Okay.
We were already hungry when they created us. Was the opening line of the prologue trailer, which has been around for a while. Maybe a couple of months ago they came back and I've finished. I don't believe I'm subject to an NDA. If I am, nobody knows this yet. But I've just recorded the lines to be the faction leader for that faction.
That's really cool. The thing you sent me there, I can probably play that, right? Is it an ad or something?
The Cravers one, yeah, that's the prologue trailer. It's you know, I know I'm biased, but it's cool.
It says Tata Hexa or something. Is that it?
No, that's a TV commercial.
Then you're in it.
I'm the voice.
Oh, it's then we've got to play that for everybody. Hold on a second.
Booking's open.
Let's see if it's loud enough.
A design perfected across
the
studios.
I'm watching your stream now, so when I'm just glancing off to one side, I'm watching the stream.
Here we go.
The best in features sourced from 8 countries. And testing of over 8 kilometers in 3 continents. Yes.
Oh, okay, so you're watching it, but nobody else can see it.
Yeah, they can hear it, though.
The Hexa. Tata Hexa. Whatever it takes. Booking's open.
Is that Chinese? It's not very loud, right?
Oh, yeah. I can hear that. Booking's open.
That's Chinese, the Tata, right? Or no?
No. Tata Motors.
India.
Tata Motors is the largest car company in the world.
Yeah, I remember hearing that. I knew it sounded familiar.
You look them up. Tata Motors own Jaguar. They own Toyota. I mean, they own masses and masses of car companies around the world. But this was a car that they were launching in India. So that was a TV commercial that I got hired to voice.
Yeah.
That aired actually on TV in India.
Oh, wow. So that got a lot of views.
2.9 billion or whatever it
is. Right. Yeah, it's like, nothing really.
Yeah, no, not too many people heard that. In fact, one of my contacts for Payday lives in India, and he said to me he saw it on TV and he was like jumping up and down, like, I know him to his mum.
That's crazy.
Yeah, it was quite fun.
Well, I guess one other thing about being a voice actor is that no one will recognize you, right? Most of the time. Person, at least, yeah.
I guess the two big benefits of being a voice actor as opposed to an on-screen or front-of-camera actor would be that if you become famous,
mm-hmm.
then you can still walk down the street and you won't be
molested.
And the second thing is you don't have to learn the lines.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, that's true. You just read it. You
know, I've been a stage actor and had to learn verbatim 70 pages of dialogue. Because you have to learn everybody else's lines as well, don't you?
Yeah, true.
It's, you know, when I was younger, sponge, you know, no problem.
Just took it all now, in. Alzheimer's. Well, you know, it's funny because I saw Tom Hanks on a TV show. He was doing an interview and he told the story that he was in an elevator with a mother and her child. And they recognized that it was Tom Hanks. And the mother said to the kid, "This is the guy out of Toy Story."
Yeah,
and,
Woody.
And the kid was like, "No, it's not." So Tom Hanks turned to the kid and said, "Look, close your eyes." So the kid closed his eyes and he did a line out of Toy Story, and then he opened his eyes like, no way! I thought that was a really cool story.
Life is like a box of chocolates. But you're gone again.
Yeah, exactly.
The only time I can do. I have a picture of me sat on that bench where he does that line.
Is that... Where is that?
Savannah.
Oh, in Georgia, okay.
In Georgia, yeah, exactly. Yeah. When I first met my wife, Sheila was living in Savannah at the time, so when I did her, I was living in Holland. I came over to visit her, and we did the whole, you know, Savannah thing.
Oh, that's cool. What were you doing in Holland, by the way? That was just through work?
Financial.
Oh, okay. Thing. Yeah, amongst other things in Holland, right?
I deny.
Oh, yeah, plead the fifth. Yeah, I've never been there either.
I'm subject to a non-disclosure agreement.
By the government?
Yeah.
Okay, that's good. That's awesome.
I went for 3 months.
Uh-huh.
And stayed for almost 10 years.
Oh, wow, you enjoyed it then.
Yeah, well, I was one of a gang of four people who... Uh-huh. Went over to see if it was a viable country for the business expatriate financial planning. And within about 2 years, I was running the business.
Oh, wow.
So I ended up staying there until the... Well, what happened then was, I guess, what was it? It was 2000. What do they call that? The bug thing? God. The millennium bug?
It was going to crash the world, yeah.
And all the IT contractor people disappeared overnight.
Yeah.
Since about 2/3 of my sales team were reliant on the IT business for their clients, the business started imploding. It was like a black hole imploding, but from a great distance. It was all happening very slowly. Took about 3 to 5 years for us to close the business down, and then that I went back to the UK and went to work for a bank.
Oh damn! Which bank was it? No, can't say. Don't want to go. Don't want to go there. No. Did you work for a bank in the US or no?
No.
No. Okay. Because I know a lot of banks are headquartered in the Carolinas. I wondered if you worked for one of those. No.
No. Having got out, I'm never going back.
No, I actually worked for a bank for a little bit too, and I did not enjoy that. Was not fun.
Yeah. Well, when I say I worked for a bank, I worked in the wealth management division of a private...
Oh, boy. Yeah.
So you weren't allowed to sit down. I wish it wasn't true now, but you weren't allowed to sit down with me unless you had over £500,000 in...
Right.
...in what they called liquid assets, so not including your house.
Right, you have to have it laying around.
Not exactly laying around necessarily, but...
Maybe invested too.
In theory, accessible.
Yeah.
So I dealt with the top, I don't know, 5% or something.
Oh, jeez.
I wish now you couldn't hire me for less than $250,000. That would be lovely, but yeah, it's not.
Well, maybe in the future. Maybe you can tell some of those Tom Hanks stories if that's the case.
Oh, yes. I remember being in elevator with Tom Hanks. We're jolly good friends now.
I'm sure, yeah. Oh my! So, do you remember any of the lines from Locke, seeing as it's 2.5 years ago?
For sure.
Is that it? That's all you got?
Well, there was a line. Anybody know any good tunes?
Anybody know any good tunes?
I think I hummed the 1812 overture.
Oh, I didn't know that one.
Yeah, that's in there
you
somewhere.
Tits are bloody professionals.
Yeah, go over to the fucking pallets and press the fucking button.
That's awesome, dude. That's great.
Yeah.
Let's see. Something about.
You kindly attach the rope.
Something about a knickerdrawer, people are saying.
Yes, something. Well, that's another line that's cropped up that I use from time to time. I can't, frankly, remember exactly what the line was, but. There's something in my mother's knicker drawer.
That's right, yeah, something about that, right?
Told my mother about it too. She did.
That's awesome. Yeah, there's something about a chopper too, I guess.
Yeah, there's a big black fucking chopper.
Oh, that's the knicker drawer thing. That leads into the knicker drawer.
Oh, does it?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, that's funny.
Yeah. Now, we don't have to learn the lines. So they go into your, I suppose the technical thing would be they go into your short-term memory and off again because you don't have to memorize them. True. So there aren't too many lines that I remember.
And I guess if you're busy and you have a lot to do, you don't really want to remember them too, right? I mean, you're just on to the next thing.
It would get crowded.
Yeah. So,
up there. I'm in awe of some of these, you know, A-class actors that, and they you know, they go on a chat show and someone says, oh, do you remember you were in a movie when you were 12? And they just recite the speech like that.
Yeah, that's pretty impressive, yeah.
She just must have a brain wired for that. Just, you know, I'm amazed.
Yeah, that's pretty impressive, huh?
It is.
I don't think I could do that. I don't think I've got the voice either.
I was in the Scottish play, I had a line that I was run away. Oh God, no, I can't remember. They have killed me, mother. Run away, I pray you. It was a line from Macbeth that I had to say.
But do you remember that from Macbeth, or do you remember it from you doing the?
When I was, I don't know, I was 12 or something.
Oh like God! That. So how many years ago was that?
No.
Hey, it was worth a shot, right?
Who do you think you fucking are?
That's awesome. That's so cool.
So, busy. I mean, I'm for this year, so 2017.
Yeah.
I've booked new work every. I've got a line on my calculator thing for every day of the year so far.
Oh, wow.
I'm pretty busy.
Well, congratulations. That's awesome.
Yeah, well, I'm happy with it. Puts food on the table.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, exactly.
A lot of it, you know, I mean, the paydays, the video game stuff, that's the exciting stuff, you know.
Yeah.
You get something to, you know, a lot of it is, we've had a very good financial year this year, and we've made an increase in our profits of 25%, and, you know, this kind of thing.
It's not
which too... I think I get those because I understand what they're talking about because I worked for.
Oh, true. Yeah, you've got
for a fucking bank.
You can have a bit of feeling behind it, I guess.
Bring it alive, dear boy. Ooh. Make it live.
Make it sound like a wizard saying it.
Who will sell widgets?
Oh, God. Oh, my dog. My dog wants to say hi, by the way.
Hello, dog.
She often.
What's the dog's name? God.
Her name is Grace, and she's a pain.
Grace.
Yeah, she likes to jump up when I'm streaming. She loves it. She's like licking my nose for some reason.
Oh, there she is.
Yeah. Bit of a pain. But
study German.
Oh, you read? Yeah, let's see what we've got here. Did you work for the Benevolent Bank? That's one of the banks in the Payday game. No. I'll answer that one for you.
You need to know, you see, where do I get my information from?
Let's see what else they got. You guys in the chat got any questions for Ian?
How old are you?
Have you played Payday before?
I have an account.
Okay.
I played the two, like the little introductory scenarios.
Yeah.
But I'm, you know, I'm not very good.
Do you play any video games or nah? Not really.
I'm not very good.
No.
The kind of games I play are the things that you can put up and put down. I just frankly don't have time to sit for an hour or two in front of a. You know, I spend half my life in front of the computer, so probably it's not healthy. But
you've already put your time in, yeah.
I enjoy playing video games. I'm not very good.
Right. Yeah. Okay. Ow! Dog just bit me. Damn.
You know, I play very gentle things like card games and.
Like solitaire and things, right?
I don't play solitaire. Here you go. I play cribbage.
Oh, yeah. There you go. That doesn't get more English than that, does it?
Yeah, that's about it, really.
Another question: Do you know if you're going to be in Payday 3?
I don't know.
No.
If I did know, I wouldn't be able to say.
Yeah, exactly. But you don't. Who do you know any other of the voice actors?
Like I said, it's a very solitary environment that we live in, and I don't live in Los Angeles, you know. So
right.
The big cities, Los Angeles, New York, Chicago, to a lesser extent, but those are the big markets, and there are most definitely very interactive voice acting communities in those cities. There are some here, and the other one, I run a voiceover social meetup once a month, and we, mostly the people come are the people that are interested in finding out about voice acting, which is fine.
Yeah,
but we have a few very high quality professional voice actors in the area. You know, for a little bow, we're not doing too bad.
That's cool.
I'll give a couple of shout outs if I may, but people might look up Lisa Biggs. So the story about Lisa Biggs is you speak to her and you get this, "Hello, my name's Lisa Biggs." And you think that can't be your real voice. Because she specializes in doing child voices.
How old is she?
Is it a theme?
I don't know. Hey, wait, I'm going to bring it back to you again soon. So
yeah. Just trying to pull full sense of security. And then you meet her, mm-hmm. and you go up to shake her hand, and she goes, "Hello, I'm Lisa Biggs," and it really is that's her voice. But you go into Toys R Us and press the buttons, the Try Me buttons on all the For Real Friends and all this. Most of them are her.
Wow.
Yeah, she's a smart lady.
And she comes to your studio? She comes to your gathering?
Yeah. Well, I know of the professional voice actors that are knocking around, as it were, locally, she's probably the one I know best.
Right.
He introduced me to the agent that I met, that he said, "I'll put you on." She introduced me to him.
Oh, cool.
There's another British voice actor up in Asheville, Mike Cooper. We've met and had coffee when I was up there at a studio for something, but Facebook chat, that kind of thing. There's another lady in Greenville, Diane Merritt. She does a lot of corporate stuff, and I started training people, and there's a lot of talent locally, and I'm to find a way to help them.
How do you teach someone to do that kind of stuff though? It sounds like something that you can either do or you can't do.
Clearly, talent, you've got to have talent.
Yeah.
Acting, if you have some acting background, so you can go to acting classes and kind of see if you can act a bit. Voice actor classes. The difference there is the use of this.
Right.
And how to get the best use out of the microphone.
Yeah.
You can, if you want to do so. So Locke, for example, try and put it like that. So I'll be a fair distance away from the microphone, but I'll have the gain turned right up.
Yeah,
got a lot of shouting to do, and you'll break it. But little quiet things like this, you want to get really, really close. Hear me almost whispering. And then you can make that sound louder later,
right.
So if you play the Cravers one, which "We were already hungry," is the recording was very quiet.
Yeah.
But it's very loud.
Interesting.
I encourage people to go and look at that. I don't want to demean Locke. He's been such fun, but you can't see him.
And
the Cravers thing, the voice is the trailer. There's cinema,
right.
Cinematographic things, movie trailer like, but it's like watching a movie trailer. I'm in awe of the people that put it together.
Yeah, especially because you kind of just see the bare bones of it, and then you just see what happens with it all.
I see anything?
Just
on the script, and then I see the words and how they've post produced it with the video later, and I go, "Oh my God, that's me."
You're like, "You did that with that."
Yeah, you made me sound good. if any of your people end up in a recording studio, there will be a recording sound engineer present, and you must be very nice to him, because not only can he make you sound good, he can make you sound bad.
Right, he can make or break you. Yeah.
A very important person in the thing is to be
that's
nice.
True. That's really cool. Do you know if the character in Payday was... Did they visually take a picture of you and do your face with that, or... Just out of interest, because a lot of them are, though, right? I've noticed at least.
Well, not with me, I don't
know. I mean, you don't look similar.
I don't think I look
but
any, not really.
I'm just going to move it. Yeah, well, I don't know.
I can't see it.
If you grew a mustache and made that face, maybe you look a little similar. I don't know.
Younger.
Yeah. How younger?
Such a round face. when I was younger, so much younger than I am today, to paraphrase. I had a thinner face.
Right, and a mustache.
Mm-hmm.
A Locke mustache.
Maybe not quite. Maybe not quite.
Not as bushy.
But I played a soldier in a World War I play called Tom. He was from North, Tom.
Oh, wow.
He had a younger voice than I've got now. I can't really do young Tom anymore. But he was the professional soldier, and he had a mustache.
Oh, nice, of course. Stiff upper lip.
There's a picture of me in that World War I uniform with the hat and the military uniform and the mustache.
Oh, interesting.
Which I have shared with someone. I might see if I can find it and put it up on my Twitter feed afterwards. See if
That's
I can
really
find
cool.
it.
That's really cool.
Anybody wants to see it?
I think a lot of people would like to see it.
I'm trying to, anybody else got anything? Jewellery store, normal. I don't know what. I have this stuff. See, because Hoxton isn't based off Pete Gold. No, he most definitely isn't.
Oh, the character, yeah, the visual. No, he's not, no. But I think, yeah, a few are, though, from what I understand.
Well, I think when you get into, like, the big, like, the Disney and the Pixar animated movies, and they've picked an A-list actor, and they do a lot of motion capture.
Yeah.
Then I think the artists inevitably make it look a little bit like, as it were.
True. Would you ever have an interest in going into any kind of acting, or you want to stick with voice?
Well, I did 10 years on the stage, which was fantastic at the time. To paraphrase Sean Connery, who I can't really impersonate him, but I can do a bit of a Scottish accent. Never say never.
So, yeah, you sound a little bit like James Bond there.
Well, thank you very much. I don't think I do, but there you go.
That's so cool. So what's next for you then?
Samsung gig.
that could set you up for a while, huh?
I don't know. I don't even know what the fee is for that. It's all been such a rush getting it together. That's with a bit of a James Bond vibe to it. They will do that very, you know, that very upright, British
stuff.
Voice.
Yeah.
What's up next for me? I've got a 100,000 word audiobook I'm working on. I'd probably have to do some of that tomorrow.
How cool is that to do?
Be careful what I say about audiobooks. They're a lot of work.
Yeah, I can imagine. How many of those have you done?
Maybe 10-ish.
Oh, wow.
So audiobooks can be anything from a few hundred words. So last week, I finished up a children's audiobook, which was 400 and some words.
Yeah, that was it.
Three characters, you know, so there's the mum has one word in it, one line in it, and then there's the boy and the robot, you know. That's called Prax and the Ringing Robot.
Oh, okay.
Everybody should buy it on Audible now.
Audible.com, Prax and the Robot.
The Ringing Robot.
The Ringing Robot. Interesting.
That actually won't be live yet, because whilst it's been signed off by the author, it's got to be signed off by Audible before it'll go live. So that'll be in a couple of weeks before that.
Okay.
What else have I done? So, one of the new things that's happening is book trailers. So like a movie has a 30-second trailer, they're now making little things about books. To tell you this. And I did a book trailer for an author, and he liked it so much he hired me to read the whole
book. Well, isn't that
interesting? Great, so a big shout out to David Penny, who is the author. The book is called The Red Hill. That is on Audible. And subsequent to that, he said, there's a second book. Would you like to read that? So I've done that for him. That's called Breaker of Bones, and is about shortly to be released.
That's very
and then
cool.
He said, I'm currently writing book four. No, he told me about some characters in book four. And then he said there were seven books, and now there are nine books. So if he continues to like them, we'll have recorded. They're called the Thomas Berrington Mysteries.
Get the fuck up!
Wow. Do you ever take any time off then? Not really, right? It doesn't sound like you do.
No, this little buddy here, I'll just unplug this one. This little buddy here. This
what is that?
It's a microphone. So,
oh, wow.
This is the microphone.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so this is a Rode NT USB microphone.
Yeah.
Which plugs directly into a computer. And then this thing here is called a Chaotica eyeball.
Okay.
Got a hole in the bottom.
Uh-huh.
They should be paying me for this. So you stick your microphone in the hole.
A bloody professional.
And then the front, this is a pop filter.
Yeah.
So the condenser bit of the microphone is there, and that's made out of acoustic foam. So once that goes on there,
yeah,
the little that allows me to be in a hotel room
and get the same quality,
50 blankets and a duvet over my head to try and get something like recording quality.
Wow.
So that's that. So even when I go on holiday, I take this with me.
Still working.
I try not to.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, for example, today, you know, agent rings you up, says, I might have a gig for you with Samsung. Can you do this audition for me? Doesn't have to be fully broadcast quality edited. And yeah. I'm in a room. Of course.
Right, of course you're going to do it. Someone in the chat says, why does your microphone have a giant ass 70s afro? I guess it does. I would never have guessed that there was a microphone in there.
It's called an eyeball because he's looking at you.
I guess I could see why it's called an eyeball. It's just very weird.
Yeah.
That's very cool.
It's a cool thing.
Yeah, that's really cool.
Cool thing.
Wow.
So, what else is, you asked me what's next. So, and we've got off the subject. So I've got the book to read. I've got to edit that as well. Have I got anything else booked? Yes, I was doing something for a student project, just waiting for the final script on that.
Yeah.
I'm sweating on another video game thing, which they had audition callbacks three times. They asked me to go back, so I'm figuring I've got to be close.
How many callbacks can you get for something like that?
As many as they want.
Right, it's like 15 callbacks later. Like,
well, there comes a point where you say, "Look, are you going to hire me? You're not going to."
Right.
But we're not at, you know, the closing the sale quite yet.
Yeah. Well, that's really cool.
So yeah, I love it. When I see video game stuff, I'm all over it. That's my. If I could do nothing but video game,
that'd be a thing.
Used to do. If I could do nothing but.
That's really cool. That must be such a cool job to do.
Well, I enjoy it.
But not easy to get into and be successful at, probably.
I think it's harder work than people might give it credit for.
For sure, yeah.
Just, you know, the colloquial, it's not just standing in front of a microphone and talking. There is more to it than that.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, there's a bit of techie skill stuff you have to come to terms with. Well, you're podcasting, you're streaming, you know, you've got to know your way around a computer and you've got to know how to get the microphones to work and all that kind
right.
of stuff.
Yeah. You got to have some confidence too, right? I mean, not everyone can sit in front of a microphone and have the confidence to speak something.
Because it's a very artificial environment.
Right.
A little 4x4 padded cell, if you like, with a microphone. And you've got to perform most of the work, you know, video games is character work, so you can be very larger than life.
Yeah.
But a lot of the work, the buzz phrase is conversational.
Yeah.
So you've got to perform like you're having a chat with your best friend. And there is a skill to that, I think.
Yeah.
But it can be trained. You were asking about, you know, can you train for it?
Yeah.
I think have some acting ability, that gets you a long way.
Yeah.
And then it comes down to technique, which can be trained.
Yeah.
And then it comes down to hard work and business acumen, because you're a small business and you've got to find your way into the market.
Right.
If nobody knows who you are,
yeah,
nobody's going to hire you. You can be the most talented actor that ever existed, but if nobody knows that you exist, then you'll get no work.
Is it also one of those things where you're only as good as your last job, or does your body of work kind of, can it carry you through a little bit?
Certainly there are, you know, repeat customers are, yeah, valuable. You know, of course you want to get those. I think that you start out and you have no portfolio, nothing.
Right.
Nobody's hired you and you've got nothing. You know, that's a scary place to inhabit.
Yeah.
And you get booked for work, then you can go to my website, for example, and you can see some examples of the work that I've done that people have said, yes, you can put that on your website. And I think that helps to elevate your profile, so that when you're pitching to somebody, you're writing a proposal letter to someone to say, you know, hire me for this job that I've seen on the website. Being able to point them in direction of a website that has a body of work on it,
yeah,
helps.
Yeah, it does.
I'm convinced that, so for video games, for example, I have an ever-growing list of games on which I have provided voice audio.
Right.
When you're approaching a game development company or something like that, being able to show,
yeah,
I'm not somebody who hasn't worked, I'm somebody who has a body of work.
Yeah.
For games that are well-known, like Payday.
Yeah.
Absolutely, I think that helps.
Has to go through, yeah. Has to carry
some weight. Helps to open the door, but you've then still got to perform when, you know, when they say, "Okay, record this." Then
you go, right. Oh shit!
It was my Aunt Betty that recorded that. It wasn't me. Better.
Let me get my 70s afro out and record this. That's so cool.
That is wow. I shall have to call her Diana Ross now. I shall have to have a name.
I think you're going to have to. Yeah, of course.
Me,
that's awesome.
Yeah.
Wow.
Oops. So anybody else got any other questions they'd like to ask?
Yeah, we got any final questions for Ian? So we're taking up a lot of his time, so his time's precious, obviously, by the sounds of it.
I haven't had my dinner yet.
Oh, no, me either. I rushed home from work and I was like, I got to get on here and set everything up. So let's see what else we've got. I'm sure there's a few more on here that we want you to say something.
We'll always love you. Yeah. So this is Whitney Houston now. Apparently this is now Whitney Houston.
Rest in peace. Oh, we need Ian to record this. OB got cuffed again. Get those bloody cuffs off. This isn't a sex novel.
All right. Copy and paste that to a private message and I'll record that for you.
Oh, that'd be great. That'd be great. What else we got? Oh, stop playing with your little dick cop friends.
Funny. No.
How about stop playing with your little dick cop friends?
Oh, well, they want me to record. I thought they were actually asking me.
Or to say it, yeah.
Can I speak Dutch? And bait you. I'm assuming Kirchhoff's is from Het Nederland.
Oh, probably. Sounds like it.
What tell me your bank ID.
Oh, God.
Yeah. It's my age is more secret than my bank ID, probably.
Yeah, and your social security number.
Yeah. Do some improv lines as Locke. No.
I think you did that already. Yeah. No.
Do improv lines. I mean, what do you mean? I mean, go fucking shoot a fucking cloaker or what?
I think they just want the four shores all the time.
For sure. Yeah, for sure. For sure. Go hunt in your own mother's fucking knicker drawer if you want some fucking money.
That's so cool. That is
what
so
are some
cool
of my other games. So Endless Space 2, Road Redemption should have something coming out soon. Craver, yeah, that's Endless Space. Kings and Heroes, Heroes and Kings. And then there's quite a few things where I've done side things for. So Bard's Tale, I've done some work for. Hang on, I forget. Let me have a look what else I've got on my list. Pitch Black Dungeon, Grim Forest, Beholder. Anybody play Beholder?
Beholder.
I did the prologue for that. Grim Forest, I did that. Did some work for some hidden object games.
Yeah.
There's a virtual reality game coming out shortly called The Cavern. I'm lead character in that.
Oh, cool.
Too few for guns and bells.
So Kirchhoff's in the chat says you pronounce his name right. So I always call him Kirchhoff's and you obviously call Kirchhoff. Him something else.
Kirchhoff, yeah.
My apologies.
Why did you just go and Kirchhoff?
That's awesome. That's so cool.
Zwei kleine Bitches, ashtublieft.
That's great.
I need a Donakdum.
Donakdum.
A Donakdum. Yeah. Donakdum, right? That sounds more Scottish. It should be Scottish.
Could you say I owe you a pint in Scottish?
What? I owe you a pint? Yeah, exactly. A Scotsman would never say that. A Scotsman would say, you owe me a pint.
That's cool.
The most interesting thing. Well, what else can I say, bad luck? Come on, boys. Yeah, I had to voice a corporate video for a container ship company.
Oh, really?
It was interesting.
It sounds interesting.
Steal the fucking ice cream. Bit off. Call me a potato.
Call me a potato.
Stupid. Light the fucking flare.
That's so funny. That's so funny.
All right. Listen, everybody, it's been a complete pleasure.
It has. It's been an honor, my friend.
So.
We will.
I'll see you all again soon. Hopefully you'll hear more of me, but
I think everyone who plays Payday wants Locke as a playable character, so hashtag Locke Payday, right?
Hashtag Locke for sure.
Sure.
Tweet that to Overkill and you didn't hear that from me.
No. That's
tweet
fine.
That to Overkill and Starbreeze and see how far it gets you.
I'll try. I met Almir not so long ago, so I've got an in, so I'll speak with Almir, right?
I heard, did I hear this right, that Pete Gold was dropped as the voice of Hoxton and the community got him back?
Oh, I did not know that.
Is that right, or did I not hear that right?
I didn't hear it, but it could be true for all I know, yeah.
I don't know.
Well, if you ever want to pick up a copy of Payday and play with me on stream, that would be great one day if you ever got the time.
I have it.
Yeah, of course, yeah. It's just the time to...
And I'm so bad at it.
That's what we want to see.
Yeah, I'll bet. You want to see Locke being rude. You know what? Here's the thing. Someone said, "What would be the most interesting? If I could wish for a future, wouldn't it be brilliant for Locke to be a playable character, and for me to be able to play as Locke?"
That would be amazing.
Be on a stream talking about being me. That would be
okay. So we have to make a pact. So if Locke becomes a playable character,
Wraith Sphere says he was dropped. Yeah.
Oh, he was. Okay, there we go.
I think there was pressure from the community that helped him get back.
To bring
him
back.
Because the Hoxton demand.
Yeah.
He set that up as a kind of a thank you.
Right. That's interesting. That's awesome.
Yeah. Playing a Locke heist. Yeah. Locke playing Locke as a Locke heist.
Being Locke. Well, if you do become a character, then you can play on here with me.
All right, that's a date.
Sounds like a plan, right?
I think I might be a bit older than I am now.
How older? Yeah. Not gonna happen.
I just set that one up for you.
Yeah, I know, and you didn't go for it. Well, Ian, it was a complete pleasure, my friend.
Well, thank you. Thank you for inviting me. It's been good.
No
nice
worries.
To talk to everybody. Enjoy the rest of your evenings or your mornings, wherever you happen to be.
And enjoy your dinner, mate.
Yeah, thanks.
I'll talk to you soon.
Take care now.
See you, mate. Bye. How do I get that? That is it, my friends. Let me see. There we go. Boom. And we're back. What a very nice guy, right? What a lovely guy. See you, Ian, if you're still watching. See you, my friend. That was super crazy nice. How long was that? That seemed like 20 minutes, but I know it was a lot longer than 20 minutes.